When we start learning electronics, we quickly get to know components like resistors, capacitors, and diodes. The main values of these components can be measured with most multimeters, but these components here are something else. Even though these may look like different components to each other, all of these are actually inductors. Because we can't measure the main value of inductor, its inductance, with regular multimeter, we either need to rely on manufacturer's data, markings on components, or get another measuring device. Back in the day, I started this hobby by salvaging components from old devices or buying them cheaply from AliExpress, and I still do that. That means I don't have the datasheet or specs available for some of my components. Now, instead of buying LCR meter, I thought DIY inductance meter should be an adequate tool for my occasional needs. If I end up transferring this to a proper PCB, you probably know who I'll choose to manufacture the PCBs. The sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com, who I have used many times in the past and will continue using in the future. For example, the microphone I nowadays use has my custom preamplifier PCB made by them inside it. Another often used PCB is this prototyping board I have designed for my own needs. If you haven't already, go check out their offering. They do much more than just PCBs these days. Inductors are components found in most consumer electronics, but when it comes to hobbyist circuits, they are not nearly as common as previously mentioned components. Some may not even know what they do. They work by storing energy in a magnetic field, and when current changes, the voltage is generated from stored energy to try and keep the current steady. Inductors can be used for different types of filter circuits, switching power supplies, and regular AC to AC transformers, as the transformer is basically just multiple inductors sharing the same core. There are various ways of measuring inductance, but one of the most common ones in DIY solutions is LC tank circuit with a known capacitor and unknown inductor in parallel. This tank circuit gets charged through a current limiting resistor and a diode. When input is turned off, this tank circuit will oscillate at its resonant frequency, which can be calculated using this formula. But because we don't know the inductance, instead the capacitor is known and frequency can be measured, formula can be changed to this in order to find the inductance from the known values. When the input voltage is removed, the voltage over this LC circuit is a decaying sine wave with fixed frequency. To make this signal readable by digital circuits, a comparator can be added to detect when voltage is positive and when it's negative. From the comparator's output, microcontroller can measure time between two rising edges or two falling edges to get the duration of one period and therefore the frequency of the oscillation. So the basic logic the microcontroller needs to do is to turn this GPIO pin high for a moment, turn it low and wait for a rising edge in this input, and immediately start counting until there's another rising edge in the input. Then stop counting and calculate the inductance value from the known capacitance and measured frequency. I'm using PSoC 4 chip and its internal comparator connected to the timer. To avoid voltage on the input pin going below ground, I have biased the lower end of the LC tank circuit by two diodes forward voltage above the ground. Now the voltage measured from the other end will swing around this voltage level instead of ground. This 1.4 volt or so offset affects both ends of the LC circuit, and comparator still sees about the same voltage difference in its inputs as previously. Like described previously, this output is high when LC tank circuit's voltage is positive and low when it's negative. Time between two rising edges is the duration of one cycle, and frequency is 1 second divided by that time. So I need to start and stop counting on rising edge of that signal. Therefore, I have connected it to the capture and trigger inputs of the timer. The trigger is one that starts the countdown, and capture is used to capture the current count. In the timer component's configuration, I have set trigger mode and capture mode both as rising edge and run mode as one shot, so it will only run once when started. I have enabled the interrupts on the capture and terminal count. Capture is when I can read the captured value and do the calculation. Terminal count can happen in undesired event of timer reaching its limits before capture has happened, and thus no valid reading is available. In addition, I have also set the GPIO pin that is used to charge the LC tank circuit as bidirectional. so I can also connect it internally to the reset pin of the timer. This ensures the timer will rest until the charging pin goes low and it's time to measure the incoming pulses. This is how the hardware looks so far. There's a PSoC chip with diodes and resistors on the inverting input of the comparator doing the bias. Then I have current limiting resistor and diode coming from GPIO pin to the non-inverting input of the comparator. These pins were selected in the design-wide resources in the PSoC Creator. There are multiple options you can choose from in your own project. Non-capacitor is connected between the non-inverting and inverting inputs of the comparator, and the inductor to be measured gets connected in parallel with this capacitor. I know going through a source code in the video isn't fun, so I tried to keep this simple and fully commented. In the main loop, I turn the GPIO pin charging the LC circuit high for a short time, and before releasing it, I enable the timer so it's ready to read the first input cycle when it comes. I wait some time, letting the LC circuit oscillate and timer to read the incoming signal, and during this time, input signal cycle length will be measured in the interrupt service routine, which I'll show soon. If the interrupt didn't happen, meaning no input signal was detected and inductor isn't properly connected, pulse length is set to 0. Otherwise, the pulse length was set inside the interrupt service routine. Then the inductance is set to 0 if pulse wasn't detected, otherwise it's calculated using the known formula. Now if the inductance value is within limits, each value will be shown to user. In the interrupt service routine, I check if interrupt was triggered by capture event, which means the length of input signal cycle was detected. Because timer counts down from the period set in the timer's configuration, duration counted in the clock cycles is that period minus the captured value. Pulse length variable used in the main loop is set to have that duration value. If the interrupt happened for some other reason, reading wouldn't be valid and I set the pulse length to 0, meaning the reading should be discarded. I also toggled the variable indicating the interrupt happened and pulse length was changed. I'm only interested in the first cycle of input signal, so I stopped the timer in the end of the interrupt service routine. This induction meter can be used to measure unknown inductors. That's handy for unlabeled inductors or if you are winding your own inductor. One very useful application for these meters is finding out the ratio of transformer's primary and secondary. Ratio of primary and secondary windings is the square root of ratio of inductances. For example, I believe this is high voltage transformer that originally was used to generate voltage in range of little over 1000 volts from 24 volts. So the turns ratio should be around 40 or a little bit more. One side measures about 590 millihenry and another side measures about 270 microhenry. That's ratio of little over 2000 and the square root of that value is 47. So I would say that is correct. 24 volts times 47 is little over 1000 volts. This project was another useful project using PSoC. Using the graphical configuration tool in the IDE, combined with easily available datasheets for each component, made configuring this one very straightforward. See you in next video. Thanks. Bye.